Good evening, everybody. Today we're flying back to Buckethead land to visit Buckethead's 12th Pike album, Propellar. So let's begin. Woo! Pike 12 was released in CD format on May 7th, 2013, with no album or track names provided until over a year later when the album was released in digital format. Better late than never. And the title of the album, Propellar, is seemingly spelled wrong, although there's been numerous misspellings of albums and tracks over the years in Buckethead land that it might well be on purpose. Who knows? The album begins with its title track, Propellar. The second longest track on the album at just under 6.5 minutes, it starts off gloriously eerie, goes into some heavy drums and rippage, before trading nylon strings acoustic noodling with more heavy rippage, then ending with an outstanding guitar solo. So many things going on in this one, and it all comes together gloriously. Track 2 is the album's shortest track, Room of Shells. The track starts off with some funky wah riffs before slowing things down with some basic blues. Though enjoyable, it's far too short to really get into the track, but its placement on the album worked well. Track 3 is the 3.5 minute Meeting at the Mummy. An excellent slow blues track that has shades of the late great Stevie Ray Vaughan written all over it. Simple, understated, good stuff. Track 4, it's The Poultry Show. An excellent rocker, great soloing, fantastic tone, and a great composition. The Poultry Show is a highly enjoyable song, the flow of this one is excellent, and for me, it's the album's best track. Glorious. Track 5 is the album's longest song at just under 12 minutes, Launched. It has a great addictive riff at the 30 second mark that Buckethead plays variations of throughout the track. The song really kicks into gear around 3.5 minutes in with a nice foot stomping beat that continues for several minutes, backed by simple pounding drums. Although long, in the right mood, its length works and is an enjoyable jam. The album ends with its second shortest track, Dome. A 2-minute creepy Death Cube Case style haunt, as a way to end the album, it works perfectly. And that for me is its intention. An outro piece to end a solid album. Overall, Pike 12 is one of the more diverse Pikes out there, covering everything from funk to blues to rock to ambient and more. Sometimes having so many different genres going on can take away from the album, but it definitely works here and makes it an overall enjoyable listen. There's no bad tracks and there's plenty on display to binge on. After adding up the rating I gave for each track, it came to a respectable 65%, which I categorise as good. And you can find my individual song ratings and breakdown on our website, natternet.com. So what's your rating for Pike 12? To work out what percentage you give the album, rate each song out of 5 stars, add up your total, and divide it by the total score possible, which for Pike 12 is 30. Then, times it by 100.